What is going on, everybody? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode number 3 of a series that I like to call Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. In this series, we take a look at the epic weapons available. I let you know whether or not they're worth the 4,000 salvage or just for getting in the armory. If you guys missed the last couple of episodes, I'll have a full playlist linked down below in the description. But for today, we're going to be talking about the Oni Kaiken. This is actually a pretty damn good pistol. And I'm actually going to start this episode by saying, yes, 100%. This is good. This is worth the 4,000 salvage. And it's not very often I start one of these videos by letting you guys know right away that a weapon is worth it. So what makes it so worth it? Let's go ahead and talk about the weapon. This is the Oni Kaiken. It replaces that fully automatic Oni with a single one-shot burst. In core game modes, this can kill in one hit at medium ranges, at close ranges, and more importantly, at pretty long ranges. I did find in certain circumstances that I was getting hit markers at longer ranges, but a majority of the time, I was able to get one-shot kills, and we're talking about core game modes here. The other benefit that this weapon has is the focus ability, which will reduce the idle sway while aiming down sights. This does help in certain circumstances while taking those long-shot kills, but a majority of the time, while you aim down sight for a split second, you're really not going to notice it. After every single shot, you need to take a moment to reload this weapon as well. There aren't any ways to extend that, and there are a lot of attachments that are actually restricted for this weapon as well. Some of those attachments being like the fusion mag. Back in the beta, the fusion mag was available for this weapon, and in fact, you didn't even have to reload it. You could YY the weapon really quick and have another charge ready to go. Now they took that away, and you have to reload every single time. I think that was a form of balancing. Another thing that you won't find is the auto sear. There's no way to make this thing fully automatic, and since it was once fully automatic, they basically brought it to a single shot mode, and that's pretty much that. This doesn't really classify as a pistol anymore. This classifies as a hand cannon, considering all of the damage you could do to any enemy that comes your way. Let's talk a little bit more about the general operation of this weapon. As soon as you pull the trigger, it will charge and fire. There's like a split second where nothing happens, and then the beam of energy will go and annihilate anything within its path. You don't have to hold it to charge it. It will do it automatically, so you just tap it once and it goes. Now, the reload for this thing is actually pretty slow. You're gonna have to really rely on that dexterity perk if you want to be as quick as possible when it comes to the reload. And even though it may look like it doesn't reload that fast, trust me, it definitely is, especially when it comes of situations where there's multiple enemies and you may need to reload as quickly as possible. Now that we know the Oni Kaiken can kick some major ass in the multiplayer, how does it fare against the undead horde in Zombies in Spaceland? Well, for a pistol that you can buy right away in the beginning off of the bench for $750, it is absolutely amazing. It is a one-shot kill all the way up until round 16. If you are using this pistol against the brutes, it takes 4 shots to kill them, 2 to pop off the helmet, and 2 to kill them. In the later rounds, it'll take up to 6 shots to kill them, but you have to remember, you're using a pistol. That's freaking crazy. Now, if you get the Bang Bang's Candy perk, you can use this thing one shot all the way up until round 20. That's absolutely fantastic. The downside to this, if you try to pack a punch this weapon, you will start to use the damage profile of the original Oni, of the base model Oni. And that means you won't have the damage that you had before, and that means that you can shoot these zombies for a very long time, and you're not going to be able to kill them as easy as you're used to, and that's a really bad thing. So until this variant is fixed within the pack-a-punch, I highly recommend just keeping the base variant, use it until round 20, and then from there try to find something better. But it just blows my mind to know that a pistol can do that good against the undead horde in Zombies in Spaceland. Once again, you have to apply this variant through the loadouts over in the main menu before you actually play the game, but once you do, it's definitely worth it. I was able to save up so many points by not spinning the box and just focusing on opening the doors. The pack-a-punch is the only thing, and once that's fixed, I'm sure that this is going to be even better of a weapon. But anyway, guys, that is going to conclude today's episode of Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. I think it's safe to say that this is one of the best pistols I've ever used in a Call of Duty game, period. It's better than the RW1 from Advanced Warfare, and it can be used as a primary weapon. That's the biggest thing about it. If I were to recommend any perks when it comes to using this particular weapon, absolutely be dexterity so you have that faster reload. Scavenger might come in handy when you are higher up in levels because you'll be able to pick up more ammunition. But if anything out there, I would recommend the laser sight for an attachment hands down, simply because if you happen to miss that shot, you're more likely to follow it up with a hip fire. So that's something that I can recommend 100%. Quick draw handle is also good to have on there for aiming down sight a little bit faster, but without that sway that you normally see with pistols, it's just going to be a lot easier to use. But anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video here today, make sure to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And until the next one, guys, I will see ya. Have a good one. Peace.